2 Kings 2, 9 to 15. I just read verse 9, then I read verse 13, 14, and 15. I just read 9 now, then 13, 14, and 15. And it came to pass, when they were gone over there, Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee. And Elisha said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. Verse 10 says, and he said, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see when I'm taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee. But if not, it shall not be so. Long story cut short, 13, he took up also the mantle of Elijah that fell from him and went back and stood by the bank of Jordan. And he took the mantle of Elijah that fell from him and smote the waters and said, where is the Lord God of Elijah? And when he also had smitten the water, they parted hither and thither. And Elisha went over. Verse 15. And when the sons of the prophet, which were to view at Jericho, saw him, they said, the spirit of Elijah doth rest on Elisha. And they came to meet him, and they bowed themselves to the ground before him. Say your amen like a thunder. The subject is the mystery of double portion. The mystery of double portion. The mystery of double portion. The meaning of that is that double portion is not just what you hear and what you think. Double portion is deeper than what you have ever been told. It's not just double portion. There's something deeper inside it that we're trying to unravel. Lord Jesus, breathe upon your word and make your word light. Make it meet to everyone. Affect our lives and feed us this morning to our full with the blessing from heaven. Let your word be a healing wing, a healing, a blessing, a promotion instrument in our lives this morning. Affect everyone, oh God, and heal and encounter us. Let nobody leave here the same. Drop your mantle of fire for double portion blessing in Jesus' precious name. Somebody say the big amen. Please take your seat. God bless you. This, what is portion? A person's destiny or lot. The destiny of a person is the person's portion. The lot of a person is the person's portion. Number two, it is an allotted share of one's inheritance. The father is dead now, and then he gives inheritance for sharing. Then he gives to one person twice as much as he gives to others. That is called the double portion, the allotted share of one's inheritance. So portion is allotted share. The word portion can be found in Luke chapter 15 verse 11, when the prodigal son came and then asked the father to give him his share of the property. The father did not argue because his son has a right to a portion of the father's inheritance. So the father divided to them. The father divided to them and gave me a portion of good that followed to me. And he divided unto them his living. The father didn't argue. He did, because that is his portion. So the most important portion of that inheritance, if we are 20 children or we are 5 or we are 6, the most important, the best of all the sharing is the double portion. It goes to the best son or the first son or the heir apparent of the throne. Amen, somebody. Number two was double portion, the largest part of a shared blessing. The largest part of a shared blessing. Blessing is shared. The largest part belongs to the man who has the double portion. Somebody here will get a double in Jesus' name. The meaning of that is when God starts blessing people, you get the best. Can your amen sound like you heard what I just said now? As God begins to distribute favor now, your own will be the biggest, the greatest. Say that amen like it's under. It is also the portion of blessing that signifies the transfer of family authority. The double portion is the portion of blessing that signifies the transfer of family authority and mantle. There is a portion that the father gives to somebody, and everybody now knows that this man now is the one who is the custodian of the authority of the family. That's the head of the family. That's the leader of the family. That's the commander of the family. So God wants to make members of Glory World commanders of their generation. Commanders of their world. Other churches can get blessed, but you get a double portion. Say amen like it under here. You stand and they stand and they know that the difference is what? Clear. The difference shall be clear this year. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So it's a transmission and a transition of leadership power. Double portion is a transmission and a transition of leadership power. The authority flows down from the head down to the next. Somebody stand up, say, I am next in line. Say last, say, I'm next in line for a miracle, for a blessing, for a promotion, for harvest, for breakthrough. Say, I am next in line. Shout that amen like a thunder. Now, what are the implications? What are the implications or significance of double point? Why should I pursue it? What does it stand for? Why is it deeper than what I think it is? I said, number one, it signifies the right of succession. It signifies the right of succession. So the person who gets the double portion is the one who succeeds the throne, who ascends the throne, the person who becomes the next in authority, the person who becomes the next in rulership, the next in leadership. It is the right. It gives you the right of succession. We saw how Abraham gave that right to Isaac. He gave his all to Isaac. We'll see again how that Isaac gave that right to Jacob. In Genesis 24, we find in verse 4 that he said to his son, he said, bring me venison, let me eat that my soul may bless you. So there are people that receive the blessing when others are not aware. The Bible tells us that Jacob was in the house with the mother when the father had this tete-a-tete with some. The father wants to secretly deliver the family right to somebody. He does not want everyone to know. So he whispered it, not knowing the mother was somewhere around the corner. The mother heard it and came and called the one, because in that family they had family politics. There are some families now that still have family politics. Amen, somebody? Mama is ganging up with some. Papa is ganging up with some. So they are polarized. Some to this side. Some. So the mother now went to the one she loved and said, I heard your father. Sit down, please. Right. Please sit down. Don't worry. The father now, mother went to the one he loved. I heard your father talking to your brother. He wants to give the inheritance to him. I will do something to make you my lovely son. Take the inheritance. The mother understood the power of the double portion. So the mother said, okay, I'm going to do. The son said, no, if my father finds out, it will curse me. Because my father, he wants to give it to the son he loves. He does not want me to even hear. That's why he didn't bring me. He doesn't want me to hate him. He didn't want me to know how he had transferred it. So he wants to give it secretly and he's doing it secretly. Don't let me get a curse. The mother said, let the curse be on me. So the mother laid hands on him and said, any curse your father put on you shall come on me. Now it is such a powerful thing that if you take it by stealing, you deserve a curse. It must be given to you. You can't yank it down. You can't pull it down. Double portion is not something you wish. It's something you deserve. Or you earn. Something you pay prices to draw down. Double portion is not something you sit and dance and say, just fall on your, no, it doesn't fall on your lap. It is a violent man taking something by force, by careful arrangement and plans. So this man called Esau fell in love with the father and was walking towards that thing. Why? He saw how that Nahor gave it to his son Abraham, and he saw that how Abraham gave it to his son Isaac, and Isaac knows what has happened to him and the difference between him and this boy they call Ishmael and the rest. So Isaac wants to give it to the one he loves, but the mother played politics on him. Now listen to me. Let me tell you something. That thing did not just happen. Let me tell you. Isaac was aware it was Jacob. Hello? Isaac knew it was Jacob. The only wahala is Isaac was so afraid to let Jacob know that he planned to swindle him. He wouldn't know what Jacob would do to him in anger. Hear me? The father heard the voice. He said, the voice is the voice of Jacob.
He said, but the body is the body of Esau. Nalai. Goat skin cannot be human skin. He knew they played Ojoro. He was aware. But he couldn't see very well. And he understood that this, he says, why did he say, come, let me smell you? He knew it. But he was afraid to let Jacob know. He played a fast one on Jacob. He didn't know how angry that guy would be and what he can kill him. So he played along. Dawo, you are not a farmer. Isaac was a farmer. Can you touch goats and not know? Tell me. Is there any human being alive whose skin looked like that of a goat? He touched the body. He knew it was goat. He felt the wetness. He understood it. But how do I... First of all, number one is, he was thinking, how did he know? What we whispered? He was not there. I asked Esau, is anybody? He said, no. He didn't. So he was afraid. Could it be that the Lord wants to give this thing to Jacob and I'm fighting God? Because he knew he was second. God gave it to him. God could have given it to Ishmael. So he didn't want to fight God. If this boy found out what I plotted in the secret, God's hand may be involved. I don't want to be against God. I must do it right. He told him that to let him know, I'm aware of who you are, but I will not come out clean. The voice is the voice of Jacob. Amen, somebody? Are you following what I'm saying, somebody? You don't swindle your way to it. And listen. If it was not Jacob's right, Jacob will die. If you wear a crown that you are not meant, how many of you watch African Magic? You go and touch Ofo. Ofo that is not your own. What happens to you? God has said things. And listen, Isaac has been fighting. There are people here. Listen, look at me. I came this morning to free you. And I will free you. Your father sees nothing good in you. Your mother sees nothing good in you. Your family members, they see nothing good in you. I came to say you are the one.
Amen.
You are the one they will celebrate.
Amen.
You are the one they will honor.
Amen.
You are the one they will stand up and celebrate.
Amen.
If your amen is louder, you'll be the first to be celebrated.
Amen.
Isaac heard from the first prophecy, there are two nations in her womb. The elder will serve the younger. Isaac wants to make it be his own thought. My ways are not your ways. Neither are my thoughts your thoughts. Somebody sitting in this house, anybody trying to take your right and give to another person, I release angels to fight for you. I release angels to pursue and recover for you. They will recover your honor. They will recover your purpose. Recover your blessing. Recover your position. There is a position that is meant for somebody, and they've been sitting on that position. My God restores it now. That job they want to give to another, my God recovers for you. Somebody shout the amen like a thunder.
Sit down.
So the conspiracy hit her up so hard that Jacob was ostracized. But Jacob is the chosen one. He looked like somebody here who is selected by God. But principalities are saying no. Selected by God. Ancestral spirits are saying no. Selected by God. Shrines are saying no. Selected by God. Marine spirits are saying no. Any force fighting your prophecy, they shall die by fire.
Amen.
They go down by fire.
Amen.
They fail by fire.
Amen.
They stumble by fire.
Amen.
That which God said you will be, you are about to become now.
Amen.
You are about to manifest now.
Amen.
You are about to realize now.
Amen.
Say, Lord, I take my place. Use 1 minute and pray now. Recover your losses. Whatever they stole, whatever they took, take it back. Take it back. I take back my throne. I take back my place. I take back my dominion. I take back my honor. I take back my grace. I take back my job. I take back my reward. I take back my harvest. Whatever is covering my life, I command it to uncover. Uncover, 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 uncover. Somebody shout fire.
Fire.
So my brothers and my sisters, Men can conspire, but God will make conspiracy expire.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody now. Whatever says you cannot rise, I curse it now.
Amen.
Whatever said you stay small forever, I curse it now.
Amen.
Whatever said you cannot get a job and take care of your family, I curse it now.
Amen.
Whoever said you suffer and suffer until you die, who is he that said a thing and it cometh to pass? When the Lord commanded it not, my God shall fight for you. My God shall fight for your family. My God shall fight for your brothers. My God shall fight for your father. My God shall fight for your friend. Somebody say, Lord, fight for me, oh. Fight for me, oh. Fight for me, oh. So Jacob appeared before Isaac. Hear me, hear me. And Isaac trembled. Isaac trembled because Isaac understands the full weight of the anger of a son who has served you all this while. Who knows that you know, and two of you have told him that the Lord said he is next in line, but you are going about to plot to throw him out. Anyone trying to take your place, I sacrifice them now. I sacrifice them now. I sacrifice them now. Your place in the office, your place in the job, your place in the contract, your place of honor. Holy Ghost! So God came through a woman. Don't joke with women, no. Women are sensitive. There are, sit down, there are some mothers who are very imbecilic. They know what is right, but because they are married to somebody who looks like Nabal, they allow their husband, who is Nabal, navigate a wrong course for the family. This woman said, I will not close my eye after I heard prophecy that the younger shall be head. I can't allow this recalcitrant human being who doesn't stay at home to come and be rewarded just because he came out first. That you came out first does not make you first. There are many firstborn who are wayward. I prophesy, any firstborn here who has a right that Satan is fighting, I recover for you. Any secondborn here who deserves the honor and Satan is fighting, I restore your honor. Whoever qualifies for the double portion, receive your share. So you see, Isaac understood the full weight of the double portion because he got it from his father. His father got it from the other father. And it's been like that. And when they begin to mention genealogy, they will mention Isaac. They will mention Jacob. They will mention Esau. And hear me, hear me. Let me tell you how powerful double portion is. God, the tomorrow is called the God of Abraham, Isaac, Addison. 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 Try Addison. But if it was Esau's hand that hand touched, Esau is the man. It will be for eternity the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Esau. Somebody, that place that your name must enter, that generations unborn will never forget your name. May your name enter there this week. As mantles are dropping, that position of honor that your name must enter for generations to come to remember you forever, your name shall enter there. That place that your feet must enter, that office your leg must enter, for people to remember you forever. I announce by the word of the Lord, your feet shall enter there. Your feet shall enter there. Your feet shall enter there. Nobody will take your place. Nobody will take your honor. Nobody will take your blessing. Nobody will take your reward. Shout the amen like a believer.
Amen.
So the father reluctantly, but under divine compulsion, laid hands. Come. He wanted to be sure again. Let me smell you. He smelled him. Then he said, see the smell of my son. He like the smell of a field whom the Lord has blessed. Then he began to pray. Therefore the Lord give thee of the dew of heaven. Hey!
Where the double go, the blessing goes.
Yes.
Where the double goes, the honor goes.
Yes.
Where the double goes, the power goes.
Yes.
Where the double goes, the promotion goes.
Yes.
Where the double goes, the authority goes.
Yes.
Where the double goes, the wealth and abundance go.
Yes.
Where the double goes, wonders go.
Yes.
Somebody here, the double is following you home.
Amen.
The double is following you home.
Amen.
The double is following you home.
Amen.
Shout the amen like a believer.
Amen.
The man collected the double. Listen to me. Let me tell you many more reasons why you should believe that Esau knew, and Jacob knew. I mean, Isaac knew. Isaac could not have eaten Rebecca's pepper soup for more than 40 years and not know how it tastes like. Sir, hear me, hear me, hear me. No matter how your mama teach you how to cook, you cannot cook better than your mother. Isaac smelled Ojoro. Isaac knew. Rebecca's hand is in this thing. Isaac knew. And the way Isaac was licking the plate. Amen.
Amen.
They will know and still bless you.
Amen.
When a man's way pleases the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him.
Oh, yes.
They will know and still bless you.
Amen.
Am I talking to somebody here?
Yes.
What belongs to you shall come to you.
Amen.
What is meant for you shall be your own.
Amen.
Nobody can take it from your life.
Amen.
So he blessed him.
Yes.
And as soon as he blessed him, Jacob knows the fury of Esau. Jacob cleared the plate without delay. Jacob evaporated. He didn't disappear. He evaporated. With all the plates, he disappeared. And as soon as Jacob went out, Esau came in. My question is, Esau, Jacob just left. You just came. Is it that you didn't notice the kitchen was used just now? This fire that is burning, how do you come? This soup. Okay, Esau, didn't you perceive pepper soup? Esau, when you entered first, because as soon as Jacob went away, was when you came. When you came back, didn't you perceive pepper soup? To tell you how recalcitrant Esau is, the Bible said Esau despises his birthright. Esau does not care about spiritual things. It will be carelessness of God to put spiritual authority in the hand of a non-entity, a charlatan, a careless Christian who goes to church anytime and goes away anytime, who does it his own way and does not care. That kind of person can't get a double. Even if you are next in line, God will orchestrate a stranger to take it. Okay, let me tell you again. Why it cannot be Esau? I'm trying to tell you what you must do. Why can't it be Esau? When Esau came back, when Jacob brought the food, look at the question the father asked Esau. He said, who are you? Say, my name is Esau, your firstborn. He said, how come you come back so quickly? Esau never comes on until 12 midnight. Send Esau one assignment. Esau will go forever. He said, Esau, are you Esau? I'm not sure. How come you came? Look at what Jacob said. See wisdom. He said, thy God brought it to me first. See guidance. Thy God brought this venison to me quickly. So forever, all this while, Esau never does a thing on time. Esau doesn't go to church on time. Esau doesn't come to choir and stay till church closes. Esau must sneak out with the bag and do like this. Esau spirit. Esau spirit. Esau always has an excuse of why I must leave, why I must go, why I cannot stay. Oh, I've got to pee pee. Oh, I feel poo. I want to fart. Everything becomes an excuse for Esau. How come you came back early? Esau, the father is surprised. In fact, even the father is surprised. Esau, when the father sent Esau, father expected this thing to run in 3-4 days. Because Esau can take 3 days to do one assignment. How come you came back, sir? All of these are the things that worked against Esau. from receiving the double. Carelessness, nonchalant attitude, lawlessness, rebellion, lack of submission to authority, wanting to have your way. The Bible says he was a man of the field. He saw, was living, he was like a smoker who hides behind the tree and smoke and then lick tom tom to clean them out and come back home. He will start practicing blowing and see if his mouth is smelling. There are many Esau's looking at my face here now. May God forgive Esau. May God recover Esau. May God help Esau. May God deliver Esau. Somebody shout, Lord,
Lord,
help me.
Help me.
That's what made Esau lose out. But Jacob was a man of the home. He mopped the house. He swept the toilet. He ironed the clothes. He washed the clothes. Jacob is, every time the father wants help, Jacob said, yes daddy, where is Esau? I don't know. Every time you're looking for Esau, Esau! Jacob the answers. Daddy, I don't know where he has gone. No, he's not around. Daddy, what do you want? But the father is a traditionalist who believes that what must be must always be. Even if God wants to change it, God has no right to change it. God will change it in your own case.
Amen.
Now let me try and stop this. My time is up. Sit down, please. Can you sit down? That is the implication. It is the right of succession. Whoever gets it succeeds the father. But this man called Isaac gave it to the wrong man, who ended up becoming the right man. And listen, to let you know, Isaac knew when Jacob Esau came back and Isaac was trying to bless Esau. He said, but who is it that came just now and told me it was you? And I have blessed him and he's blessed. And he cannot be cursed. Amen? Isaac could have lied to Esau. And Isaac is a truthful man. He let him know that you will serve your brother. He told him clearly. He could have said, he lied there. Okay, forget the SDC. Come, let me bless you. And Esau will believe he's blessed. But Isaac cannot. Isaac knows spiritual things. He does, that thing does not happen like that. Once it is given, it is given. He said, and thou shalt serve thy brother. And hear me, it was Isaac who called Jacob and said, pack your bag, run. I know Esau. He's a murderer. He will kill you. It was Isaac who gave Jacob his brother's address in Haran. Run! Esau will kill you. He packaged him well and said, don't let him know. Do as if you're going on errand. Evaporate. That's why Jacob only carried one rod and one oil. He didn't carry back one oil and one rod. Why? Because if Esau ever suspected that you were on the run, Esau will let you even go out of that, then he will come after you. And Esau is a man of the field. Esau will catch you before 5 minutes. Jacob is a Jebota. Jacob cannot run. So Jacob walked with rod as he is going to buy oil. As soon as he got behind the backyard, serious. 20 years again, Jacob has not come back. And nobody knows. Esau kept asking the parents, are you not crying for? In fact, the parents pretended as if they thought that Jacob had died. They began to cry, to mourn. But they knew he had gone. That's how I knew that Isaac was a part of this thing. Friends, don't let nobody take your crown. No matter what they do, don't allow them. Fight for your crown. Are you there, somebody?
Yes.
This week, listen, mantles are going to be falling. All of you sit down. I use them as example to everybody. Something is, a crown is coming on everybody's head.
Amen.
A crown is coming on everybody's head.
Amen.
My hand is touching them. Everybody sitting here now, the hand of God is sitting on everybody's head.
Amen.
Depending on your connectivity, your harvest shall be released.
Amen.
Your answers shall be released.
Amen.
Your blessings shall be released.
Amen.
No power can deny your next level.
Amen.
This amen can sound like a thunder here, somebody.
Amen.
No time, so let me stop. Can I stop? Do I add one more? One more. It signifies the right to recovery and restoration of kingdom, wealth, prosperity, and possession. Wherever the double comes, that man has the authority to recover kingdom, wealth, kingdom, prosperity, kingdom, possession.
That is why everyone who was ever blessed with such authority and such double, that man became wealthy in his generation. Abraham, wealthy. Listen, if you get the grace for double portion, if you enter Kalahari Desert, it becomes a forest. There is no place that won't answer to a career of double portion. There is no business. If they employ you mistakenly to a company that was dying, once a career of double enters, the company revives. Do you hear what I'm saying? Be careful who you marry. 1, 2. Be careful who you employ. 3. Be careful whose compound you live in. But again, be careful who you are allowed to stay in your house. Be also careful who comes to marry you, who you accept proposal from. Then be also careful who you bring to your company. Because if the company has an evil foundation, the man entering will corrupt the foundation. If the man was a cursed man and was meant to be cursed for life, if a good woman with a double enters his life, he corrects the error. Somebody here, every evil you come across, you correct it.
Amen.
Whatever was not working that you become a part of, you will make it work.
Amen.
Oh my God, I wish Glory Wall is here. Whatever was folding up, once they bring you in, it shall bounce back.
Amen.
Can I hear your amen again in the house of God?
Amen.
I command businesses to open up.
Amen.
I command jobs to open up.
Amen.
I command companies to open up.
Amen.
I command families to open up.
Amen.
I command compounds to be unveiled.
Amen.
Every darkness covering your compound, by the grace of the oppression, you will cancel the darkness.
Amen.
You will scatter the evil.
Amen.
You will frustrate the wickedness.
Amen.
Any wicked landlord sitting on the destiny of tenants. Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! When the double comes, a change must occur. When the double comes, a miracle comes. When the double comes, a turning point comes. When the double comes, a shift comes. I announce to you, there is a shift in your favor. There is a movement in your favor. Things are about to turn around. Turn around. Turn around. God says, I will overturn. I will overturn. I will overturn. Until it comes, whose right it is, and I will give it to him. The hour has come. As you return from here, they will give you your right. They will give you your honor. They will give you your position. They will give you your blessing. They will give you your breakthrough. No more denial. No more frustration. No more stagnation. No more limitation. If anybody shouts a loud amen, receive it. Say, Lord, I want a double. Lord, give me my double. Lord, give me my share, my double portion, my higher grace. Open the door, bypass protocol, and bring my miracle. Open your mouth 1 minute now. Whatever you must do, Lord, do it now. Whatever you must change, Lord, change it now. Whatever you must turn around, Lord, turn it now. Whatever you must open up, Lord, open it now. Yagadiga lagadia, eleperegadeo, elesoterigataya, la parava katara de, exekiri girigata, karadiga la dobaswata, ekadila katulaga bragada. Lord, give it to me. Give me my share of the property. Give me my share of the blessing. Give me my share. I have served this man. I have labored in this house. I have stayed here long enough. Don't let me die a small man. Don't let me struggle again. Don't let me suffer again. Let there be a shift. Let there be a promotion. Let there be a new level. Let there be a new level. Turn my life around. Turn my story around. Somebody shout fire. Please sit down. Sit down. I can't mention the purpose, the blessing, and the benefit for time's sake. But how? What are the steps? What are the steps to enjoy my double portion? Some steps that Elisha took. Some steps that Jacob took, some step that Abraham took, some step that made sure he didn't miss it. Be prepared for the position you desire. Be prepared for the position you desire. Do you want a double portion? A double portion is not just a title, it is a responsibility. A double portion gives you an assignment. A double portion gives you a mission. A double portion imparts upon you something to be and something to do and something to release. Please sit down. Be prepared. That Jesus took 30 years to prepare for 3.5 years of double portion impact. We can never forget it for eternity. Joseph took 17 years to prepare. From when he heard from God, 17, to when he became prime minister, 30, 17 years. Amen, somebody? Can I talk to somebody again? David heard sings, you will be king. You can be anointed but not announced. There are many anointed men here, ordained but not announced. It is preparation that leads to announcement. Sir, any day they announce you something, the attention of principalities turn in your direction. Woe betide the man who has received the announcement and is not prepared for what is coming. Ascend spiritual throne carelessly. I'm the next in line. You are like a bloated balloon. Your name is Goliath. One small pin will boom and you are dead. You will not die carelessly.
Amen.
Prepare for the office. Prepare for the throne. Elijah, do you want a new level? He said, 40 days eat, for the journey is long. That one. Moses prepared in the universe of Egypt 40 years from childhood. And then God said, that is physical preparation. Now let's give you spiritual. And took him to the desert 40 years leading sheep. Sheep are the most stupid animals. When you tell sheep, don't, sheep can see fire, Aaron, and walk into the fire and pass. They behave like mumu, like him beside. God said, if you can lead sheep well, I will teach you patience. You didn't have patience. That's why you killed the Egyptians quickly. Moses is trained in a school of martial arts. He has to happen now. He clears the way one time. But in God's kingdom, you don't clear the way. You persuade men. You must learn diplomacy. You can't be a leader who wants it your way. Stop! Two heads are better than one. HODs, seek counsel. When you seek the counsel, receive the counsel, and let's rearrange it together. Don't say what I say stands. Who are you? Are you God? Are you God? Only God is without error. Anybody saying I am leading, but nobody is following him, is simply taking a walk. The difference in leadership and walking is that people are following the leader. That's the reason for this congregation. You can't lead and not be followed. But when you rule, you can't be followed. Many leaders are rulers, dictators, tsunamis. Am I talking to somebody? Go back to the school of preparation. Before man too falls. Listen to me. Hear me. Time, don't finish. Hear me. That nonsense you don't want to correct now. Now that you are still small, the day will come when you are a senator. It will make national headline. Now you're making mistake. Nobody's hearing it. Once you sit on the double portion seat, you are the news of your generation. Every camera is on you. News agencies are on your matter. You enter a hotel, secret cameras are watching you. Your enemies who don't want you to last in your throne will go to paid hoteliers to record clips about you. Do you hear what I'm saying? You're playing now, and it looks like nobody can forget that thing, man. I'm just enjoying that. And they jive, man. And they flex. You will soon become a flex banner. Oh, yet go some.
are learners. Hear me? Readers are leaders. Learn. What did I say? Leaders are readers. Hear me? There can never be a leader who is not a reader. He will make a colossal mistake. He will cause cataclysmic effects. When he falls, the ground will shake. You better go and check. If that does not speak to you, then nothing else can speak to you. Anybody who is ready here, receive your share. Receive your share. Receive your portion. Anybody ready here, let the crown rest on your head. Let the mantle rest on your head. Let the blessing rest on your head. Let a new chapter announce you now. Stand up and shout, yes!
Yes!
Lift your hands, let's go. Lift your hands up. Wave your hands. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
I love you.
I love you.
I magnify you.
I magnify you.
Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
I will not miss my season.
I will not miss my season.
I will not miss my moment.
I will not miss my
hour.
I will receive.
My double portion mandate. I will lead my world.
I will be the head.
And not the tail.
Hey,
hear me now. There are many CEOs hearing my voice. The Lord just told me now.
Yes.
What will happen this week? I will make billionaires out of these church members.
Amen.
They will open businesses and it will rise like rockets.
Amen.
And there are businesses already now that are struggling. By the grace upon this new altar, by the grace of double portion, I command those businesses to revive.
Amen.
Revamp.
Amen.
Explode.
Amen.
Open up.
Amen.
You will win that contract and start crying.
Amen.
Because since you were born, if they had told you they would give you a contract of some 15 billion, you will not believe. Somebody here, the money you have never had before, receive it in 2021.
Amen.
Receive it in 2021.
Amen.
I command a new connection.
Amen.
I command new opportunities.
Amen.
I command new platforms.
Amen.
I command new helpers.
Amen.
I command destiny support.
Amen.
I command a financial deliverer.
Amen.
Let them enter your life now.
Amen.
It will be clear to you that God gathered you here.
Amen.
To make a star out of you.
Amen.
Lift your two hands and give him praise.
Thank you, Father.
We give you praise.
Thank
we
you,
bless
Master.
You, Lord.
We worship you.
Thank you, Father.
Jesus.
Thank you,
blessed be your holy name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Amen.